Hello everyone, today we are going to start next series of our NAVARD examinations. Okay, today also we are going to discuss some important questions related to the NAVARD examination. Okay, so let's start the lecture without delay. By watching the previous year questions or by analyzing the previous year questions, you get a way to in which direction your preparation must go. Okay, then after watching the video, you must go through the content related to the questions that has been shown to you in the video. Okay, our first question is, which of the following soil covers maximum area in our country? Okay, options are alluvial soil, black soil, laterite soil, red soil and peat soil. Okay, now see, this is very simple questions and answer is alluvial soil. Okay, what is the answer to this question? The answer is alluvial soil. Okay, now let's know something about alluvial soils, which is the most important type of soil for that is found in our country. Mostly this is the highly fertile soil. Okay, it covers an area of near about 143 square kilometer. How much? 143 square kilometer. Okay, means you can say that about 43% soil of our country is alluvial soil. Okay, you can say alluvial soil as a deposited soil, also transported soil and by rivers and streams. Okay, actually there are two types of, you can say that in alluvial soil. One is new alluvial soil, that your new alluvium, that is known as khadar, and other is old one, that is not, one is khadar and other is bhangar. When you talk about the khadar, this is new alluvium and this is old one. Okay, this khadar is means if it is newly formed, then it is sandy and light in color, and this bhangar is dark in color and clay. Okay, khadar soil is more fertile. Khadar soil is more fertile but less in organic matter, while bhangar is less fertile but more in organic matter. This was all about the alluvial soils. Now next is our you can see black soil. Black soil, you should know a little bit about black soil also. In near about 15% of the soil in our country is black soil. This is soil as rigor soil also, and this is the best soil for the cultivation of cotton. It is known as mature soil also or late soil also. It has high water retaining capacity, it has shrink well potential, self-plugging is one of the characteristics of black soil. The montmorillonite mineralsy dominant in black soil. Other is laterite soil. Near about 12% of the soil is laterite soil. Then is red soil, seen in mainly the area where rainfall is low. Red soil is also known as early soil. Okay, red soil is red in color due to the presence of iron oxide. Okay, and next is peat soil. Peat soil that is found mainly in the peat soil that is found in Kerala, that is known as carry. Okay, in peat, there is two type of soil. One is peaty soil and other is muck soil. In peaty soil, organic matter is more than 50%, while in muck soil it is 20 to 50%. But the matter is that in peat, this organic matter is undecomposed, while in muck soil this is decomposed. That is the reason muck soil is more fertile. Okay, after that we move to next question. Which of the following is most serious virus disease that has affected the poultry industry? Okay, you must have Ranikhet, ball fox, influenza, Marek disease, anemia. You all are knowing the answer to this question, that is Ranikhet disease. Okay, let's know something about Ranikhet disease. It is acute, highly contagious viral disease of poultry, and all age groups of the poultry birds are affected by this Ranikhet disease. It has caused heavy economic losses to the poultry industry, as it has high mortality rate, means 50 to 90%. Mortality rate is 50 to 90%, and there is a high drop in the egg production. First case of this disease, Ranikhet disease, synonyms is Newcastle disease also. Then first case of Newcastle disease was recorded in 1928, where in Ranikhet near Almora in India. And that's why it is known as Ranikhet disease. It is caused by paramyxovirus. Paramyxovirus. Okay. After that, this disease is spread through the infected feed, water, and air. Although airborne, this transmission is the most important way of transmission of this disease. Whatever the these symptoms, loss of appetite and gasping, difficulty in breathing, sneezing, coughing, nasal discharge, paralysis of one or both legs or wings, drop in egg production. These are the symptoms of this disease. Okay. Next is, what does R stands in Govardhan Yojana? Okay. Recreate, reform, rain, resource, or rodents. Okay. See, first thing, this Govardhan Yojana was launched under the Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation. Okay. In Govardhan is now, in this Govardhan means, governments galvanizing organic bio agro resources dhan scheme. Okay. Means answer is resource. This scheme was where it was launched. This was launched at NDRI, Karnal. Okay. And what was the aim? The scheme was aimed to just positive means in this to give impact on village cleanliness and generate wealth and energy from cattle and organic waste. Okay, this was the main of the detailed explanation of the Govardhan Yojana will be given to you when I will give you in when I'll teach you the different schemes of government. Okay. Inarching grafting method is practiced in which fruit crop? Coconut, papaya, mango, orange, or banana. Okay. See, the inarching method, you see, you have to remember the commercial method of propagation of various crops and fruit crops. Of this, suppose you if you talk about the apple, then it is propagated by whip and tongue method. Peach, tea budding. Otherwise, you talk about avocado, layering or tea budding. Amla, patch budding. Like that, if you talk about the pomegranate, then hardwood stem cutting. Again, persimmon, then crown grafting. After that, if you talk about mango, in mango, in arching is done. Okay. Although if you see in mango, veneer grafting, inarching, softwood grafting, that is also done. But the question is asking that inarching grafting method, then according to the options, our answer is mango. Okay. Now, after that, if you talk about the bear, then ring and tea budding is done in bear. When you talk about the this rubber, then forked budding is done in rubber. Okay. Then the different method of commercial propagation, you have to remember, because from this section questions are asked. Swasth Dhara Khethara is slogan of which of the following government scheme? First option is Enam. Second is Pradhan Mantri. There is some mistake in this. It is a Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana, PM Kisan. And last is soil health card. Then, now, first thing we are talking about Enam. This was launched on 14th April 2016. Okay, but it was approved on 1st July 2015. Enam means National Agriculture Market. This is Pan India Electronic Trading Portal. This was its main motto was one nation, one market for agriculture commodities. That was Enam. Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, this was to provide insurance to the crops. In that case, for Rabi crops, you have to pay premium of 1.5%. Kharif crop, you have to pay 2%. Again, annual or horticulture crop, you have to pay 5%. I told you the detail. I am going to teach you the different schemes in details. Okay. Then regarding irrigation, the other Yojana was Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana. In PM Kisan, financial assistance is given to farmers of 6,000 per year. In a three different installment of 2000. After that, the last is soil health card. Soil health card, this slogan, Swasth Dhara Khethara, that is slogan of Miss Healthy Earth in Green Farm, that is the slogan of soil health card. It was launched on 19 February 2015, at Suratgarh, Rajasthan. Okay. When you talk about soil health, it means it contains information about the nutrient status of the soil with respect to 12 parameters and nearly 3 macrometers NPK, 1 secondary nutrient sulfur and zinc, iron, copper, manganese, boron. These are the micronutrients, and some are physical parameters like pH, electrical conductivity and OC, organic content. Okay, generally soil samples are taken two times in a year when there is no standing crop in the field, and the farmers are provided soil health card once in a 2 year. Okay, technology driven farm revolution is golden revolution, white revolution, gray revolution, evergreen revolution and round revolution. See, yellow revolution, so there are different revolution. If you talk the blue revolution, that is related to the fish production, brown revolution that is related to the leather production, golden fiber revolution that is related to the jute production, gray revolution that is related to the fertilizers. Okay, golden revolution is related to the fruits or honey productions. Okay, after that, when you talk about the evergreen revolution, that is the overall production of agriculture. This was the first farm revolution, this technology driven farm revolution. Round revolution is related to potato. Okay, when you talk about the protein revolution, that is for higher production, means that was a technology driven second green revolution, that protein revolution. But here is a technology driven farm revolution, and then in option there is evergreen revolution. Answer will be evergreen revolution. Next is, Muga silk is largely produced in which of the flowing state? Okay, Assam, Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra. Yeah, of course, the answer will be Assam. Muga silk, that is also known as Muga. After that, this largest area is Assam. And this silk is endemic to northeastern India. India has monopoly in Muga silk cultivation. Okay, after that, nature is semi-domestic, multi-bovine or bivoltine. Bivoltine means two generations of this are completed in a year. After that, this is about Muga silk. Then answer is our Assam. Which stage is not Atal Social, Asal Solar Kirsi Pump Yojana? Okay, then UP, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Tamil Nadu, West Bengal. First, you must know that this scheme was launched by the Maharashtra government. Under this scheme, the government of Maharashtra has decided to give two LED bulbs, a DC fan, a mobile charging socket as a favors to farmers. And this scheme also provides subsidy of up to 95% on the solar pump sets. After that, only those farmers are eligible under these schemes which have land of less than 5 acres and will have to pay only 5% of the cost of 3 HP solar pump, while farmers with more than 5 acres will get 5 HP horsepower pump for ₹30,000. Okay, then answer is Maharashtra. Which of the following scheme is NABARD sponsored scheme? PODP means Producers Organization Development Fund, WDP means Watershed Development Program, and TDP, this is Tribal Development Program, for this A and B and all. But you must know that all the PODP, WDP, NTP, these all are the NABARD sponsored scheme. The answer will be all. Now we have various courses. You can see that we have the courses for the NABARD also, but that will cover only the agriculture portions. That is now available at $799. You are getting at near about 40% discount. And the various courses, we have near about 4 courses of the AFO. One is that complete courses. You will have pre-recorded classes, PDF note, test series, summary sheets, doubt session, everything will be there. Other, you can take the PDF notes plus test series, or you can take only the PDF notes at 999. Okay. See you in next lecture. Thank you.